recruited to the British Secret Service from the Royal Navy. Licensed to kill, and has done so on numerous occasions. Many lady friends, but married only once. Wife killed.
All right, you've made your point.
You're sensitive, Mr. Bond.
About certain things, yes.
Détente indeed.
Every person who even comes into contact with that microphone is to be eliminated.
What's going on, everyone? Great Talon here, and today we're going to talk about James Bond 007 in The Spy Who Loved Me, 1977 James Bond flick starring Roger Moore. So my last review, I really didn't care for Your Eyes Only, didn't really like that too much. Spy Who Loved Me here isn't that much better. I mean, it's okay, it's all right. I'll give it some kind of credit. The opening is pretty cool, a ski chase. Jaws is in this movie. Richard Kiel's back playing Jaws. Returning performance. A very rare thing to see for a James Bond villain. I don't think, besides Blofeld, I don't think the leader of Spectre, I don't think there's ever been a returning, I'm trying to think of my history of James Bond, or the history of James Bond. I don't think that a villain or a henchman has returned in a second movie like Jaws has. I guess he was just so well received that they decided to bring him back. And he is just such a badass. Like, whenever he's on the screen, he just commands the presence of the screen, and it just very, very formidable ways. And I'm just gonna say, spoiler alert here: he goes toe to toe with the shark, and he fucking wins. That's all I could say. But no, this movie, it's okay. It's pretty decent. The plot goes where James Bond, Commander James Bond, has to figure out who is leaking some type of microfilm to, like, it's like during the Cold War, so he has to figure out who's leaking the microfilm that allows the Russians' submarines from tracking their submarines to try and launch nukes from underwater and get the codes and shit like that. You know, Cold War shit. And along the way, it takes him across Cairo, Egypt, the vast oceans and whatever, the waters. Another very aquatic James Bond movie. And he's working in tandem with a Russian KGB agent named Triple X, who's pretty fucking ridiculously stupid hot, of course, because why not? That's the Bond girl of the film. And yeah, of course, they end up banging, because why not? Because James Bond. And yeah, no, but she's also, again, a typical run-of-the-mill revenge plot, where she's out for revenge because in the beginning of the opening credit sequence, James Bond actually kills one of the Russian KGB agents she's actually intimately involved with. So she's like, oh, I want to work with you now, James Bond, but when the mission's over, I'm going to fucking kill you, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, whatever happens, happens. But and the main villain, though, of this movie is a little lackluster for me. I mean, he kind of doesn't fill the shoes of Blofeld. He's like Blofeld light. He's like this evil German-esque guy who's just, they make him seem ruthless, but, you know, he's just sitting behind a table for the most part of the movie, you know, like Emperor fucking Palpatine or whatever, but not nowhere near as cool. Other than that, you know, the action scenes are pretty decent, pretty spot on. There's a lot. If I must say one thing about this movie, it tries its little heart out. There are so many explosions and explosions going on in the movie that it's like, huh? Like, you feel like you're like going, what? Ah, like you're going deaf by the end of the movie, but it's good though. It tries. I mean, I honestly, to be fully transparent here, I was drifting in and out of the movie. Like, it had me at some points, other moments it didn't. The beginning and the end of the movie was probably the best. You know, the opening, the starting, first act and the final act. In between, the middle act, that's the problem with these James Bond movies from the 70s. From the late 60s, early 70s, all throughout the 70s, and a good part of the 80s, they're just like, they start off strong, they end strong, but the middle section is like, shrug. Like, it's like, eh, meh, you know, it's just like, why can't we have a good second act? Why can't we have an engaging and enthralling second act? Why do we gotta throw this shit out the window and it's just, ugh. But there is a cool train section that involves Jaws, I will say that. But anything that involves Jaws and Richard Kiel on the screen is gonna fucking be awesome, because Richard Kiel is a fucking badass powerhouse. He's like fucking Godzilla incarnate. He's just a fucking beast. The man is a beast. And there is another cool scene with Jaws and a magnet, so keep that in mind if you ever watch this movie. But can I recommend this movie? And what is my score going to be? So, all right. Basically, if I had to score James Bond 007 on a, for The Spy Who Loved Me on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm going to give it a tried and true 6.5 out of 10. It's a fair movie. It tries. It's almost borderline good. It's just still lukewarm to me, unfortunately. Like I said, it starts off strong, finishes strong, but there's that big chunk in the middle that's just like a snooze fest, unfortunately. And yeah, so it's another one on the lower totem pole for me on the James Bond. If I have to rank them, like, I'll have like sections where I put them in the upper echelon and the lower echelon. This is going in the lower echelon pile, next to Live and Let Die, Diamonds Are Forever, and for Your Eyes Only. So yeah, and with that being said, that is my little take on James Bond 007 in The Spy Who Loved Me. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. The next movie I will be doing is Timothy Dalton. We're entering the Timothy Dalton era, so we're going to do The Living Daylights. The Living Daylights is next, folks, so stay tuned. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thanks, as always, for stopping by. I'll catch everybody next time.